In this screencast, we're going to show you how to use the checkbox control for user forms in VBA. So as always, when we need to go to VBA, we click on the Developer tab and go to Visual Basic. We can also just go Alt F11. And as I showed you earlier, we're going to insert a user form. We're going to rename the user form as checkbox, and we're going to change its caption so it says checkbox. The next thing I'm going to do before I even put anything else on there is put a quit button. So we'll call this quit, and we'll give it a caption that says quit, and we're going to change its font to 16. In addition, we're going to copy this, so we use the command Control C, click over here, Control V, so we've copied a command button, and now this one we will call Go, and change its caption to Go. And notice that we don't have to change the font. Once we copied it, the font stayed in there. So let's go to our toolbox, and over here is our checkbox. So what we're going to have the user do is choose between methane, ethane, and propane. So here's our first one, our first checkbox, and let's name that methane, and let's change the caption to say methane, and finally let's change the font here to be 14. Okay, we're going to click on it, Control C and Control V, which copies it. And let's make ourselves a little bit more room here. Notice you can select more than one thing and move it. And then we're going to go Control V, which gives us our final checkbox. So this one's methane. We've already taken care of that. This one we're going to name ethane. And we're going to change the caption to say ethane. And finally, this one, we're going to call it propane and change the caption to say propane. Now, if you notice, the three of these are not lined up. And let's say we want them all to be lined up like methane. So you go over here into the properties and you look down to see where it says left. And over here, it says 42. So for each one of these, we want the left, which is 36 here, to be 42. And notice what happens. And then we go to the propane, where its left is 36, and we make it 42. So now they're all lined up. Let's put the code in for quit, which is unload. And remember, we call this checkbox. Go back to our user form, and now let's put in some code for our go button. So the syntax that we use is if methane, and it is a Boolean, which basically means if methane is checked, then, and we'll just say message box, you checked methane. Now, what if it's ethane? So we use the word else if. Notice it's one word. So if we check ethane, it'll say else if ethane, then message box, you checked ethane. Now we can do the same thing for propane and say else if, but there's no other choices. So all we have to write is else message box, you checked propane. And then we always have to finish it with an end if. So let's see how our program looks. One of the things you can do if you don't want to go back to Excel or insert a module while you're checking your user form, you go up to this run button here and say run sub or user form. So we're going to run our user form and we're going to check methane. Says go, you checked methane. So now we're going to uncheck this and check ethane, you checked ethane. And finally, we want to check all three of these, you checked propane. There's one issue with this program, however. What happens if you check more than one? Well, it takes the very first one. Or what happens if you don't check any of them? Then it takes the last one, since you had that as your only final choice. So in the next screencast, I'll show you how to get rid of this problem.